Other than that, some very good weather about over the next day or two. That's all.
Thanks, Bears. And now, finally, in this evening's programme, I'm afraid we have to bring you not a shaggy dog story, but a soggy dog story. It comes from Hayling, Ireland, and the reporter responsible is John Andrews.
Simon Jennings is quite new to the sport of sailboarding, and he wouldn't claim to be the world's best just yet. And if he does start going in for competitions, he'll have to leave his Labrador retriever, Purdy, at home. She seems to think the board is there for her amusement. Purdy would always accompany Simon to the beach when he started sailboarding, and she happily swam alongside, that is, until he fell off. Then she decided she could do better. She needs a little helping hand to scrabble onto the board, but once there, she's a real sea dog. Before the sailboard came along, Purdy made do with chasing sticks and retrieving balls during those family excursions to the beach.
She's always sort of come down the beach swimming with us, and when I eventually bought the sailboard, you know, she just thought it was sort of another mode of transport, you know, just like she'd get in the car to come for a walk, she'd get on the sailboard and come for a sail.
How did it happen the first time?
Purely by accident. You know, I was just sailboarding around, she was messing around going for stones. Next thing I know, her feet were up on the board trying to come and join in the fun.
She obviously loves the water.
Yeah, I can't keep her out of it. It's like a pet seal, rather than a dog.
And every time you're on the board now, she comes with you, does she?
Every time. Well, if she doesn't, she's disgusted.
And does it make it more difficult on the board with her extra weight on it?
It was a bit
few months before our move, we'd been